Here, this particular skrill is a concurrent skrill, because if you see transaction T1 and T2 in this table, not all the instructions of one transaction are completed first and then the second transaction starts. It is not happening here. You can see few instructions from T1 are executed, then a chance is given to transaction T2 by CPU. CPU switches in between to transaction T2 and it executes some instructions from transaction T2, and again it comes back to transaction T1 and it completes the remaining instructions from transaction T1. Similarly, after completing transaction T1, it goes to transaction T2 and it executes the remaining statements from transaction T2. Okay. It means that both the transactions are happening simultaneously. They are executing simultaneously. That's why we can consider this particular schedule as a concurrent schedule. Two transactions are running parallelly on the same CPU, right? So this is a concurrent schedule. Let us check now. This particular schedule is going to keep our database in consistent state or not. Another question to you is, another question may be asked in your examination like this. Question number 3. All the concurrent schedule keeps the database in consistent state. This is the statement, suppose, given to us. We have to prove that whether this statement is true or false. Statement is true or false, then again you have to justify your answer by giving suitable example. So this is a question for us. We have to consider few schedules which are concurrent schedule, and let us check the way we checked in previous example whether that concurrent schedule keeps the database in consistent state or not. Now we have schedule number 3 in our hand. We will check whether schedule number 3 schedule 3. So we are going to check the consistency for schedule number 3. You can refer this particular schedule where we are going to execute transaction T1. In between we have transaction T2 and then we are coming back to transaction T1, then T2. This process goes till the both the transaction gets completed. So let us start again by considering initial balances of consider initial balance initial balance balance of account A has 1,000 rupees and account B has 2,000 rupees in it. Now we are in transaction from T1. Let us execute these statements from transaction T1. First statement is read A, then subtract 50 from account A, and then we perform write A. Let us execute this read A if I do in transaction 1, then I'll get 1,000 rupees as the balance in account A, because we consider the initial balance in account A has 1000 and in account B has 2000. So here I will get 1000 rupees. The next line is A equal to A minus 50. Subtract 50 rupees from account A. So I'll get 1000 minus 50, that is 950 rupees in the account A. Then I will perform write A operation so that it gets updated in account A. So this is the updated balance now in account A. Let us go to the schedule. Check. Are there any statement? Next statement? No. From transaction TO till now, all the instructions are completed. The CPU now switches to transaction T2. It means that we have to go to in transaction T2. In transaction T2, the first instruction in transaction T2 is read A, find 10% of amount of account A, then subtract it from account A and update it. So we'll go to first perform read A operation in transaction T2. When I perform read A operation, here I'll get 950 as the answer. Okay. Then I have to find the 10% of account A. 10 equal to A into 0.10. So it goes to 950 into 0.10. So it goes to 95 rupees. Subtract it from account A. A equal to A minus 10. So that goes to A is 950 minus 95. Okay, let us perform it on calculator. It is 950 minus 95. The answer is 855. So here we'll write 855 as the answer, and then we perform a write A operation. When you do write A operation, this would be the balance, final balance in the account A. We have completed few part of transaction T2. Now CPU switches from this T2 to T1 again. So again we have to go to transaction T1. So I'll write this in transaction T1. What is the next statement? We have to read the balance of account B, add 50 rupees into it, and then perform write B. So here I am writing read B. What is the value here? Tell me, student. If I perform read B operation, right now it will show me 2000 rupees. Then B equal to B plus 50 rupees into it. So the final total goes to 2000 plus 50. And that is 2050 rupees. It gets updated only when I perform write A operation. So write B operation. Here 2050 amount in account B. We completed all the instructions from T1. Transaction T1 come to an end. Here back to now transaction T2 in transaction T2, the first operation that we are going to do is read B. Read B operation, and the result would be 2050 updated balance. Okay. Then we have B equal to B plus 10. B equals to B plus, and the value goes to 2050. What was the value in 10? 10 variable value was 95. So I will add that here. 95 here. And the total goes to 2050 plus 95. The result is 2145. 2145. rupees in account B. Update it by writing this operation. Write the operation is 2145. Okay, so if you now check after performing both the operations, the updated balance of account A, it was 855, and in account B it is 2145. After performing transaction T2, let's update the balances of account A and account B. Because if you see, transaction T2 is performed right operation after transaction T1 performs right operation on account A. So we will consider the updated balance of account A from transaction T2. Let us check what is the value it is. In transaction T2, write A operation. It is here. It is 855. Right. Then, if you again check the schedule number 3, the transaction which performed the write B operation last. Again, it is a statement from T2 transaction which performed the write B operation. So, last updation is done into account B is by transaction T2. So we will take that updated balance from transaction T2, write B operation. So here it is. This 2145. Let us calculate now the updated balance of account A and account B. A plus B after performing transaction T2. In account A, it was 855 rupees. In transaction T2, when you perform write B operation, it is 855 plus the current balance of account B, updated balance, it is 2145. 2145 rupees. And the total value goes to 2145 already in the calculator. I'll add 855 into it. And the final value is 3000 rupees. So it means that before performing the transaction, the total value in the balance of account A and account B was 3000 rupees, whereas after performing the transaction, the updated balance in account A and account B is again 3000. So from this we can say that the schedule S3, which is a concurrent schedule, also keeps the database in consistency. Till now there is no problem. Schedule 1, 2 and 3, we checked all the 3 schedules and they are keeping our database in a consistency. But there may be some concurrent schedule which does not keep your database in a consistent state. Not all concurrent schedule keeps the database in consistent state. Some may keep the database in consistent state, like schedule number 3, but some may not, right? So let us see the next schedule number 4. Now you can check the last line. Schedule 1, 2 and 3. We checked for sum of balance of A plus.